So my name is Sourabh. I graduated from NUS a long time ago. You probably don't have seen me in the university. I started my first startup, which was a regular tech startup, and then decided to plunge into doing something which creates more meaning in people's lives, right? So I just wanted to do a quick check. Do you guys recognize the picture? Do you know what this is? I'm sure it's a familiar thing. Can we switch off these lights so that people can see it more properly? The yellow lights. No, switch off. The other way. Right? Okay. The yellow lights. Okay. I guess you guys can see it better now. Right? So you guys recognize this picture? No? It's the picture of the tin can, which is there on every NUS rag and flag day. Right? So I'm sure many of you have put some sense into this at some point in time, right? How many of you have given a donation, let's say, in the last 6 months? Raise your hands. Right. Great, awesome. So you guys are very good. Right. Do you know actually whom that money went to? Or forget that, do you know actually how much percentage of that money actually reached the end beneficiary? Right? I also had similar problems when I used to give. Clickers. So the problem with donation, which I felt, and I'm sure every one of us kind of relates to that, is the moment you put that money in that donation box, you don't know where your money is going. More than that, you don't know how much of that money actually reaches the end beneficiary, right? And what impact it caused. So this is not a blue box. This actually is a black box. And still, we keep giving money into it because sometimes giving is not so much about the other person, but it's actually about guilt riddance, right? You want to move on with the day, right? I grew up in India, and in India, this is a familiar sight. Why in India? I think even in San Francisco, you have street beggars, right? They come to you, you ask for the money. Here, at least you know the person whom you are giving the money, and you know how much is reaching that person, right? Sounds good. But I don't know, when I was young, my mother, whenever I used to give money to these beggars, my mother used to discourage me. She used to say, don't give money to the beggars because you make them helpless. And I did not understand that concept at that point in time. But much later, it actually dawned upon me that when you give money free to people, it actually not necessarily help them, right? It can actually cause more harm, right? So this is what we were hoping, that how do we change all of this, right? So how do we reinvent charity, so to say, right? So along with some of my friends, we actually started out and said we have to change this, right? Change the way people give every day, right? So what did we do? So the first question, how much of the money actually reaches the end person? We said, let's keep it 100%. 100% of the money which you give should reach the end beneficiaries. No questions asked, right? And how do we do that? We set up two bank accounts. There is one account in which all the public money goes and helps to fund the beneficiaries, right? And how do we fund ourselves is separately. Myself, my co-founders, and some of the other team paying the usual bills is through separate, right? So there is no mixing of the money at all, right? Then we said, okay, how do we engage the people? Because one of the main things we see is that when we give money, we are not getting proper feedback as to how the money is being used, who the person is getting it, right? So we said we have to engage the people. And how do we do that? We say, let's put the face of the person who is getting the money so that I know to whom the person whom I'm giving money to, I know who else is giving the money, and I also know what impact it is creating. And that's very, very important, right? And the third thing we said is it should be something in which everyone can get involved, right? And I don't mean everyone in a small way. I mean everyone in a really big way. Till now, giving is something which someone comes up to you and says, okay, I want money, and then you think about it, right? We want to make it part of every day's activities. It should be as usual as you eat, as you shop, as you go on Facebook. It should become part of your life, right? And I'll tell you later how we are doing this through our organization. And the third thing we said, and I was still not happy. I said, this is great. But I don't know why, still the amount of money which we give is always like 0.01% of what we earn. Which is fine, because our hard-earned money, right? I mean, everyone here is not a Warren Buffet which can give 99% to charity, right? I mean, he can survive with 1%, but I mean, people like you and me, I can't survive even with 110% of my income. So we said, there has to be something which we can do. So we said, why don't we give the money back to the people, right? Make it more sustainable. Let us give the money back to the people, not 10%, not 20%. Let's give back 100% of the money to the people after it has been used by someone, right? This way, it becomes completely sustainable. It's like giving a loan to a friend, right? Maybe then people will start to give larger amounts of money back as for doing good, right? So it started last year in June 16, 2010. We did a sort of fundraiser, you can say. We said we're not going to talk about the projects as such. We are going to put the pictures of the people who are going to get the money and let people choose to whom they give the money, right? And we raised $5,000 in flat 8 days time. And then we went on to Osmanabad. It's a very, very small town in one of the states in India called Maharashtra. And we gave out this money to women who needed the money to actually sell solar lights, actually sell water filters, actually sell those small toilets which people can use. And then we saw that these women, by selling them, some of them became healthcare women, and they started teaching, started doing those cataract operations to prevent blindness, right? Some people opened up a shop and started selling goods. And we saw that their income actually increased by 7 times. So for every dollar which we collected, they were able to generate 7 times income. And we thought, this is really good. How can we do more, right? What actually happened here, right? So we saw that if you give people an opportunity, they can actually change a lot, right? And if you give that opportunity by giving it as a loan, it changes everything. Because then the solution is not top down. It's not a big foundation coming or a government grant coming and saying, okay, we'll build toilets in this entire village. Right? It's a solution which is bottom up. It's demand driven. Right? Imagine telling a person who does not have money for a toilet, right? First telling them you need a toilet. Then telling them, if you don't have money, I'm ready to give you a loan for the toilet, which you can return it back to me, right? So he makes sure that he makes good use of that money. So we saw that people, when you give them as a loan, they engage the entire community, right? They bring in their neighbors to help them build the toilet, for example. Here in the case, this is a solar energy installation, right? So, and they make sure that they are using the money for the right purpose and for their betterment, right? And when you give it as a loan, people want to make sure that they are able to repay back the loan, because they have to repay, they need to generate higher income. Right? So we ended up creating jobs for people by giving loans. So this is another thing which we did, where people were taken a course which tells them basic English and computer skills. It's just a 2-month course. These are people who have done their A-levels but have not gone on to university for various reasons, mostly financial. And then by the 2-month course, they're suddenly able to get a job in the formal sector. When I say formal sector, in the sense they have insurance and stuff like that, right? And it was also able to create assets which people feel that they own it, right? So here's a lady who has a toilet and she takes care of the toilet. They don't use it as a storeroom anymore, right? She has a water filter. And as I said, it also helps in creating awareness. So telling people about the hygiene issues, why they need to not defecate in the open, but actually have a toilet, requires a lot of education of the community. And it also leads to, and when apart from hygiene, it also requires to teach them dignity, that having a toilet is actually a very good thing, and you don't have to open up your pants in the open, right? So till now we have changed around 4,000 lives, but this is a very small number, and we actually want to reach 1 million lives changed. And this 1 million lives, because, I mean, I can tell you entire stats about poverty as to how many people don't have toilets, don't have electricity. But I think the most important reason why we want to change 1 million lives is because the stories of change which we hear, right? When Wasim, as I showed you earlier, this guy who had done his A-levels but was just helping out with his father in some odd jobs, right? He gets a job and he starts earning $300 a month, right? When you see Ramya, whose mother bought this solar light, the mother is using solar light in the house, but she is using it for study in the night, which she was not able to do earlier. Or she was studying in the dim light of the kerosene and also inhaling all the kerosene fumes. When you see Veliamma, where we built toilets, so before the toilet was built, she actually had to get up at 4 a.m. or 5 a.m. and in the dark go inside a forest or behind a bush to release herself. And she's probably 50 years older than me, and she had to do that, and it felt so sad. So when we went and we saw that the toilet was built, she just looked at us and folded her hands. And this is the happiness which we get from doing all this. This is why we feel like doing more and more. And we hope that this idea of changing the way we give is spread out to as many people as possible. So I just want to end with a small video, which I hope will play. So I hope you find this idea worth spreading. Thank you.